We now want to perform available expressions analysis for the program in the given control flow graph. For a change, we want to represent sets using bit vectors, and we have assigned bit positions to expressions as follows. We call expression A star B as E1 and it occupies the first bit position. Expression B star C is E2 and it occupies the second bit position. Expression C star D is named E3 and it occupies the third bit position. Expression D star E is called E4 and it occupies the fourth bit position. So in basic block 1, we have expressions A star B and B star C whose availability is generated. So we have the availability of E1 and E2 being generated. So the first two bits are 1 and the bit number 3 and 4 are 0. Similarly, in basic block 2, expression C star D is generated. So the third bit is 1, rest of the bits are 0. In basic block 3 and 4, there is no expression computation, so the set gen is empty and all bits are 0. In basic block 5, we have D star E, which is expression E4, and we have expression A star B being computed. So therefore, we have E1 and E4 as expressions whose availability is generated. So we have bit 1 and bit 4 as being 1. In basic block 6, we have the expression E4 being generated, and therefore we have this bit as 1. As far as the kill information is concerned, nodes 1, 2, 5, and 6 do not have any assignment. We have not shown any assignment. So therefore, their kill sets are empty and the corresponding bits are all 0. In basic block 3, there is an assignment to C, and this assignment kills the availability of expression B star C, which is E2, and expression C star D, which is E3. Therefore, E2 and E3 are killed within basic block 3, and therefore we have the second and the third bits as 1, whereas the remaining two bits are 0. Basic block 4 contains an assignment to D, which kills the availability of E3 and E4. So we have the kill set as E3 and E4 and is represented by the first two bits being 0 and the last two bits being 1. Now we have shown here the expected result of available expressions analysis, and we would like to perform our analysis and actually get this result. At the start of the program, no expression is available because we've assumed that all variables are local variables. So therefore, at the start of the program, no expression has been computed before. At the entry of basic block 2, we have expression A star B available along this path. It is also available along the looping path because within this loop, neither A nor B has been modified. However, although the expression B star C is available along this path, it is not available along this path because the value of C has been modified, and therefore only expression E1 is available at the start of basic block 2. At the start of basic block 3, we have E1 available for the same reason as that in basic block 2. Additionally, we have E3 available because E3 has been computed in basic block 2. Similarly, we have E1 and E3 available at the start of basic block 4. Note that at the start of basic block 5, we have D star E and A star B being computed. However, we have only A star B as available. D star E is not available because D star E has not been computed along this particular path. Besides, there is an assignment to D here. So we have only E1 as being available. At the start of 6, we have D star E is available because D star E is computed here and A star B is computed here. So we have E1 also available. Now, if we observe these nodes, E1 is available, but in node 2, E1 is not computed. In node 3 and 4, no expression is available, so there is no possibility of any common sub-expression elimination. The only possibility of common sub-expression elimination then we have is in nodes 5 and 6. In node 5, we have expression E1 available, expression A star B is available along this path, but we also have an upwards exposed computation of A star B within node 5, and therefore E1 is redundant. Similarly, in node 6, we have E1 and E4 both available, and E4 is computed, and this computation is upwards exposed, so therefore E4 is redundant in node 6. So we define we perform our data flow analysis by initializing all values to the universal set 1. Note that this is an intersection problem, so therefore we have to choose universal set as the initial value, and in this lecture we'll look at slightly more intuitive reason why we use universal set, and in module 2 we will try to see why universal set is the right initialization. But at the start of the program we have boundary information which is empty set. So at all nodes we perform this initialization of all ones, and then we start performing our analysis. As we perform the analysis, we discover here that we have expression along, so at the exit of node 1 the values are 1100, which says that the expression A star B is available and B star C is available. Here at the entry of 2, we take an intersection of this exit value and the previous and the initialization at 5, which is 110, and therefore initially we say that this expression that are available at the start of 2 are expression A star B and B star C. Now in basic block 2 we have the third expression being computed, so at the exit we get the value 1110, which is the value at the entry of node 3 and 4. Now in node 3, because E1, E2 and E3 are killed, therefore bits 2 and 3 become 0, we have only bit 1 as being 1 here. In this block, expression E3 and E4, in expression E3 and E4 are computed, so the bit E3 becomes 0, E4 is already 0, so we have out of 3 as 100 and out of 4 as 1100. Now we compute the in of 5 as intersection of these two, and therefore the result is just 1100. Now 1100 implies expression A star B being available here. Now we have expression D star E is computed here, its availability is generated, because within this basic block we have neither E being defined nor D being defined, so therefore we get the fourth bit as 1, and then we get the availability here at the in of 6 as 1001, and we continue to get 1001 because the expression D star E which is generated here is already available at the entry of this basic block. Now we perform the second iteration. In the second iteration, we need to take an intersection of 1100 and 1001, which gives us the value 100, and that 100, to that we add 101, we add the third bit, the third expression is being made available, and therefore we get the bit vector 1010, we get 1010 here. Observe that in the last example, in the previous iteration, we did not have bit 1, we had the other bit also as 1. Now what we want to do here is we want to perform the next iteration, and when we perform the next iteration, we find that the values do not change, and this is our final result, and it's easy to see that this matches the computation performed here.